broadcasting for a worldwide audience.
Hello and welcome to another edition of Electronic 80s. My name's Ian McLuckie. Let's start in 1986 with the last hit that the Electric Light Orchestra had, Calling America. Light Orchestra and Calling America from 1986. Let's go back to 1983 now. And from their second album, The Art of Falling Apart, Soft Cell, and a song that didn't do particularly well as a single, number 25 it reached, Numbers.
Numbers. Who's the person that you woke up next to today? If you were any older, then you know you'd have to pay your way. Well, maybe you do already, but you make out they pay you. Did you ask yourself, where did love go wrong with you? Forget to take all reminders when you go. Good things have to end, and I was never any good at saying goodbye. Because when I say goodbye, a silly thing happens, and I always cry. Have you seen your face? Now you're really going to see the plain numbers. 2 in a 9, 5 in a day, and you never know their names. Because names make a person real, and there's no real people in these games.
I'm
First of all, from 1983, we had Soft Cell and Numbers. And then we had Mark Almond on his own from 1984, from the Vermin and Ermine album, And You Have. Let's go to 1986 now, from the Pretty in Pink album. In fact, the Pretty in Pink soundtrack, OMD, and If You Leave.
Like I need you there, you're all
One of their greatest hits. I only reached number 48 in the charts. OMD and If You Leave from the film Pretty in Pink. From 1982 and Talk Talk by Talk Talk. It reached number 25. That was a follow-up to Today, but it was actually a reissue. They first of all issued that one first, and it only reached number 53. Then they had Today, which reached number 14, and then they re-released Talk Talk, and it reached number 23. Anyway, enough of this drivel. And I'll give you the Thompson Twins now from 1984, from Into the Gap album, Hold Me Now.
I have a picture pinned to my wall, an image of you and of me, and we're laughing with love at it all. But look at our life now, all tattered and torn. We fuss and we fight and delight in the tears that we cry until dawn. Thank you.
trees. It's coming.
Hounds of Love album, Kate Bush and Hounds of Love, the title track. She's making a bit of a comeback at the moment, isn't she? Let's move on to 1984.
We'll be right back.
from the movie Highlander, starring Sean Connery and Christopher Lambert. That was Queen, and Hammer to Fall. It was also featured in, they sang it in Live Aid as well. Let's go to 1982 now, and Joan Jett and the Black Hearts.
The record machine. I knew he must have been about 17. He was going strong, playing my favorite song. And I could tell it wouldn't be long that he was with me, yeah, me. And I could tell it wouldn't be long that he was with me.
Always be.
Oh, this might not last too long.
from 1982, Spandau Ballet and Instinction. It reached number 10 back in 1982 from Diamond album. Let's go to 1987 now and Marillion and their Incommunicado. We'll be right back.
Notorious.
One of the successes at the recent Jubilee do and at the Mall, Duran Duran, when they actually sang Notorious. That's going back to 1986 and it reached number 7. An offshoot of Duran Duran, of course, was Arcadia, and that was and we'll go back to 1985 for that and Election Day.
I'm burning out.
Arcadia and Election Day. That's it. I'm done for today. Thanks very much for listening. I hope you can tune in again whenever you've got the time. My name's Ian McLuckie, and I'll say bye-bye, and I'll leave you with Private Investigations by Dire Straits. Bye-bye. Thank you.
Radio Lewes. Local community webcasting.